Hello, Star Soul. I'm Paula Golden Ray Twin Flame Earth Angel, and this is our Twin Flame Divine Love Reading for the 19th to the 25th of June 2017. And this week includes the gorgeous and beautiful solstice energies for Twin Flames and Divine Love. Well, let's begin our reading. The masculine crowns with the Ace of Earth. A central card is the Five of Air. And his foundational card is the Seven of Fire. So let's start with his central card for this week. And it says, an unwise choice. Learn what you can from this situation and review everyone's motives. Okay, so this unwise choice, this could be a choice that the masculine has made in the past. It could be an unwise choice made by his partner, business partners. It could be an unwise choice you may be thinking about at this point in time. But so just be aware of that, dear masculine, that there could be an unwise choice that you're focusing on or could be happening this week. But then your foundational card is the Seven of Fire, and it says defend your beliefs and decisions, stand your ground and choose your battles wisely. So if these unwise choices are, you know, through someone else, you can, you know, defend your ground and stand your ground and move forward with passion. Because your crowning card, the Ace of Earth, is about the inflow of abundance and a promising business venture, important documents or contracts. And there's a beautiful light of wisdom here to guide you on your way. That beautiful angel is guiding you. And now let's go to the feminine. And her foundational card this week is the Queen of Air. And it says, objective decision making, clearing away all that no longer serves you, and seeing the humour in a situation. And the central card for the feminine is the Nine of Earth. And it says, enjoying life's little luxuries, spending time alone, successful self-employment. That's gorgeous. It's beautiful. And her crowning card is the Wheel, Archangel Michael. So things are turning, things are changing. And it says a time of positive change. A situation suddenly moves forward. Fortune is on your side. So you could have a very lucky week this week, dear feminine. And with Michael here, he's really crowning for you. He is watching over you and making sure that things are moving in your positive direction. So you can relax this week and really enjoy these beautiful energies surrounding you. You know, and whether these luxuries are just, you know, some time alone or, you know, some beautiful, healthy self-care, or whether it is your successful self-employment. And, you know, the foundational card is the Queen of Air, so you're able now to see the big picture, to see what's really going on, and see here how he's, like, they can't move forward, they're all sort of, you know, hanging around in a big bunch, but here she can see her beautiful twin, her divine love, rushing forward. She can see the bigger picture. She can see his higher self. So she knows everything is going to work out fine this week. And now let's go to the higher energies for both. And for the masculine, it's simplicity. And this card says, bow to that which is simple, You'll find answers to your most complex issues and those questions that seem to defy the possibility of an answer. You'll find the solution now through simplicity. Live one day at a time. Have gratitude for whatever you possibly can, even if you're yet to understand why you should be grateful, because you cannot perceive the gift hiding within your struggles quite yet. Trust in the goodness of life, seeking to serve you in becoming the fullness of all that you are. Yes, beloved, even in your darkest night, the light of love is serving you. The most sophisticated of problems can be resolved through a simple answer, love. Trust and have faith and be patient. Wait and you shall see. Let simplicity be. This oracle brings you an answer. Everything's going to be all right. So when you need to take a clear and simple action, you'll feel it. Relax and know it's all going to work out for the best. So there you go. You know, don't be involved in all this sort of carry on in the ego matrix and getting drawn into, you know, whatever others are doing. You stay, you know, your higher self is telling you, just beautiful masculine, to stay on your path. Jump on your dragon, you know, really, you know, make your love and your passion the foundation of your week. Don't get drawn into this, because this beautiful angel here, the Ace of Earth, is helping you to see clearly any unwise choices. So keep it simple, dear masculine. And the higher energy for the feminine is yin-yang lover. The force of attraction is stronger than your conscious control. There's no need to fight this inner genius. You can learn to speak its language instead. What is it that captures you, that pulls you close, that holds so much light for you? Why fight it? Don't step away from what you really love. It's waiting for you, and it's yours alone, beloved. No one else can claim your own divine birthright for you. By yielding and letting your desire fill your body, your heart and your mind, you don't have to fight for what's already yours. It'll come to you through the field of attraction that emanates from your own heart. It's not a question of worthiness or deservedness. It's not a question of trying to work out what you need or you want. Your heart already knows. So listen, and if you still can't hear, then just feel it. This oracle has a message for you. No matter whether you seem to be heading closer to your goal or further away, you're making real spiritual progress, and what you want is the same thing that's wanting you. What you're seeking is seeking you, and it's only a matter of time before you get it. Wow. So maybe the feminine is, you know, all the work she's been doing, she can fully integrate all this now, and you know, make the sort of moves that, you know, maybe would seem impossible in the ego matrix. And that move is to just, you know, see the bigger picture, really love and enjoy your journey and your life and where it's going, because you've got the protection of Archangel Michael here to guide you. And now let's go to the unified energy field for both. And it's the celestial rose of Ma. And this card says, a spiritual gift is on its way to you. The celestial rose of the Divine Mother is a precious offering of sacred love to the soul. That love can lift you beyond what you have known, beyond self-imposed limits, by the uplifting fragrance of grace. You're going to begin to think thoughts that you've never dared to think before, and you'll feel moved by life, by its sacredness, in a way hitherto elusive to you. You'll feel ecstasy without apparent cause, and you'll feel as though every breath is a seductive caress of the heavenly lover. You will be open and surrendered in a way you've longed to be, but in a way you've never quite known how to go about. And this spiritual gift signifies the ending of a period of suffering and the opening up to a time of new opportunity, a flourishing and thriving release of your unique soul fragrance into the world. It's a gift worth having. So then, you know, the only thing about the rose is that it does have thorns. And that thorn may be a love that you need to let go of now, so you're open to your present rather than your haunted past. Your thorn may be the fear that if you grow too vibrant and embrace the magnificence of your being, others will shun you out of jealousy or fear and leave you alone. So if your thorn is, you know, something that you've felt suffering for a long, long time, you can let that go now. Your ready for love heart can be free from expectation and instead be open to life with curiosity and reverence. Well, the thorns have served their purpose, and you know, whatever your thorns are or have been, be willing to deal with them, to face them, and most importantly, to release them without any doubt, shame, guilt or recrimination, beloved. They have served their purpose. And that has been completed. The Celestial Rose of Mar promises a gift worth so much more than any pain you're holding on to. So release to receive now. Can you sense that beautiful fragrance opening up to you now? And isn't it gorgeous that I've chosen to use a rose candle this week? And the unified energy field says the Celestial Rose of Mar. So let go of those thorns in the ego matrix. They could be, you know, people that are trying to stand in your way and confuse you and stop you moving forward. That's not going to happen this week because you've got this beautiful angel of wisdom, the Ace of Earth, and, you know, it's all about moving forward with love and with purity. And of course all that comes with simplicity, because anything hard and difficult is whatever's going on in the ego matrix. Love is the purest, easiest, simplest thing of all. I mean, it's what we're created for and what we're made for. And the beautiful feminine is, you know, she's watched over by Archangel Michael, and she has abundance too this week, an abundance of just feeling beautiful, feeling herself, you know. Time alone is a beautiful abundance as well. And, you know, success, successful self-employment. It's really time to move forward on your gorgeous spiritual path, because now you can see the bigger picture. And you know what's happening. Now let's have a quick look at these cards that appeared at the bottom of the deck. And in the matrix, we have life experience. A significant life event, a powerful revelation that leads to change. Time to spread your wings. And time to spread your wings right there and right there. And, you know, with that beautiful healing, there's the passion. There's the butterflies that signify new life. There's the gorgeous birds in the air. And all this is saying that through your life experience, you have learned, and especially now on this gorgeous journey and this path, that you've learned to let go of whatever is hindering you in the matrix. You've learned to see with clarity what's really going on. And the cloak is the card at the bottom of the deck for the individual higher energy. And that fits perfectly, because the cloak is, you know, what we've worn in the matrix. It's, you know, the fears, the doubts, the, you know, protecting yourself from, you know, perceived enemies or negativity. And, you know, that's why the cloak is telling you to throw off that cloak. It's now time to let that go. And, you know, that brings you the simplicity. You don't have to keep hiding under this cloak. And Yingling lover, I mean, rip off that cloak. And, yeah, it's all about passion and love. And the card at the bottom of the deck for the unified energy field is Sacred Convergence. And that is just perfect for the solstice energies, because it's the balancing of the masculine and feminine energy. And that is where there is the sacred convergence. And sacred convergence indicates a coming together of souls in alignment with a greater cause. The common soul purpose may be to lift each other into greater love and self-belief, to shed fear and open your heart for the holy fire of your passionate purpose. And it says, this oracle has come to you because you're part of a greater sacred convergence happening now. And there's also a special message here. Perhaps you've been thinking about shedding lower vibrational connections based in the ego world of power games, sabotage, manipulation, and fear. Perhaps you've already begun this process and have shed so many you're fearing you might have overpruned to be left with nothing and no one. Do not fear, angel of love. Your truth is prevailing. And you cannot stay in a vibration of fear if you want to dwell in a vibration of love. So this is all about your own choice and, you know, to trust your intuition, because it is all coming together now in the sacred convergence, and you'll definitely be feeling that in these gorgeous solstice energies. Well, thank you for joining me this week. I'm Paula, Golden Ray Twin Flame Earth Angel Fiend. Thank you for joining me, and have a gorgeous, lovely week. Thank you.